Pelling. middle, you know, you can see the four, this thing, no? One middle, yeah. These are the four seats.
That photograph, no? That's four of these people.
Yeah.
Yeah, three of them are the saints who came from different part of Tibet.
So and the main saint is the center. On to his right is the Chogyal. And the other two. Yeah. I read it there.
Wait, so this is here also, no?
Maybe, but we can't read it.
So he was the first king. He was the first king.
Yeah.
And these three, are the saints, you know, who came from different parts of Tibet in those areas. And he recognized
this man
as the first king of Sikkim. And it was coronated here.
They anointed some water on his head and made him the...
Yes, that was the water from the Kartok lake.
Yes, exactly.
And you can see... It was made in some saint's name. This was not before, but later on they made this stupa.
Okay.
It's made of five elements. In which, after death, the body symbolized, you know, and get peace in heaven. So, in Buddhism, everything, in Hinduism or Buddhism, everything is made of five elements, air, either fire, water, or. So when they make this, they put bone and ashes, valuable scripts, you know, valuable stones and all, they put it inside and they make this stupa. Their dresses, you know, the traditional dresses
they were wearing.
It's kept in Jangu, the place which I showed you, the place, you know, named Jangu on the way to Lachung. So there is a monastery
there.
Tholung Monastery. It's in the high, we have to go trekking to that monastery. It's kept there. In every 4 years, you know, they take out the dresses for the people, you know, to get gashing. You can see the footprints. Okay, footprints.
Covered and kept.
So this was a this is the footprints of the saint, you know. I don't know which saint, but
maybe the main
tree.
Thank you.
Tang Chin Zonga.
Right. And the meaning?
The golden mountain.
The water comes out once in a while. Is there anything inside? No water now, no?
Totally dry. Yes, it comes once a week. Sometimes summer. Then also it's not there every day.
Okay. That's quite funny, you know, these boards by ASI. Oh, that's enough. Bless.
It's so nice anytime you pass through a particular spot which reminds you of your ancestors, or you get to think about them, you spend moments remembering them and commemorating their life by making these stupas where you are just picking up stones and stacking one on top of the other. You stack five and you have a stupa. And this
is more stupas.
The ancient site is only 100 years old, you find the walls, the width being, you know, much larger. Now we do 12 inches, 14 inches, and these guys are doing in capital of Sikkim, Tenshan Namgyal, the second Chogyal of Sikkim, and the son of Phung Chog
Namgyal shifted the capital from Yuksum to Ratnenche in
view of the mountains. You can see the mountains from here also. Male, female, both are there.
That everywhere they have kept both. Here also, this one also. Both are there.
This is lady and that
yeah,
one.
I don't put boards here.
Ah, but this is the one.
The word Ther, it is a Bali word which means senior or elder. The main language used by Buddha was Pali because it was the language of common people. Mahayan, as the word suggests, Maha means large and Yan means vehicle. So many things are immersed into Mahayan. There are very similarities between Mahayan and Shaivism, Kashmir Shaivism, Hinduism, and Mahayanis don't consider Buddha to be a common man. They believe Buddha to be a supreme deity, residing in the heavens, giving boon to the people. And along with Buddha, there is a large army of deities in Mahayana. There is Amitabha, there is Avalokiteshvar, there is Maya, there is Tara, there is Brahma, and there is Mahakal. So there are many deities in Mahayana, unlike Theravada. So, and the literature of Mahayana is in Sanskrit language. Sanskrit was the language of elite. This shows similarities between Mahayana and Hinduism. So all the literature of Mahayana is in Sanskrit language. The differences between Mahayana and Theravada. Theravada considers Buddha as Shakyamuni, a person born into Shakya clan. By his continuous efforts, he attained Buddhahood. And Mahayana considers Buddha as a god. There is no concept of image worship until Kanishk. In Theravada, Buddha only said, "My Dhamma will be the guide," which are the Four Noble Truths and the Eightfold Path suggested by Buddha. So Theravada is pretty simple. Mahayana is very big. And there are a lot of scholars and contributors to the literature of Mahayana. From Mahayana emerges Vajrayana. Vajrayana is completely Tantric Buddhism. And there are clear influences in Tibetan Buddhism of regarding Vajrayana. So Tibetan Buddhism completely practices Tantra. So there is Padmasambhava. There is Padmapani, gods which are worshipped other than Buddha. So Mahayana is pretty big as compared to Theravada. But Theravada is completely based on simple messages and sermons of Buddha, which is the Four Noble Truths and the Eightfold Paths. And this shows as Buddhism crossed the geographical borders, there were many variations and local practices and rituals were also adapted into it. So, and by the course of time, there were many changes into Buddhism.